Ah, your 30s. That wonderful time discovering your first grey hair. Hangovers that last 2,000 to 3,000 years. No, thank you. And weekly phone calls from my mother that start with, "Why are you not pregnant today?" Truth be told, I'm not the only one disappointing my mother by not currently breeding, despite my age starting at a three. More and more women are having children later in life. 20 years ago, the average age of the first-time mum was 26. Now it's 30. Which has some people, my mother, freaking out about leaving it too late. But should we be freaking out? I mean, some of the stats around women's fertility are, how you say, a little bit funky. I'll explain that in a second, but first. Hello.
Hi, Anna. How you doing?
Nice to meet you. I'm Jan.
Hi. Good colour.
Yes.
Great taste.
Yes. Fiona is one of a growing number of women in their 30s who are grabbing fertility by the balls, or more accurately, by the ovaries.
So you decided to freeze your eggs?
Yes, I started thinking when I was about 35, because that's the age everyone says that your fertility starts to decline.
So how old were you when you actually decided to go ahead and do it?
37. Well, I'd come out of a long-term relationship. At first I wondered, oh, maybe I'll meet someone and I'll sort of get engaged and get married quite quickly, and then found that dating in Sydney is quite tricky. And so I think I need something to buy a little more time.
You discovered what every Sydney-sider knows to be true.
What I didn't want was to meet someone, say when I'm 40, and then to try IVF and for it not to work, thinking that I could have done something earlier to improve my odds. So
the odds Fiona is banking on is the idea that at 35 your fertility rapidly declines, the so-called fertility cliff. And where do we get this idea from? Everywhere.
Female fertility drops at about age of 35.
Fertility takes a sharp drop after the age of 35.
A woman's fertility starts to drop from age 35.
From a purely biological perspective, it's best to try to start a family before you're 35 years old.
Also banking on these stats are fertility clinics, who are increasingly encouraging young, healthy, fertile women to avoid the so-called cliff. Which is partly why 2 years ago, Australia's first dedicated egg freezing facility opened up.
Booties, and we have to put on a gown, and you have to put a hat over your bum.
Oh.
This is where eggs and embryos are frozen, in all of these liquid nitrogen tanks. There are thousands and thousands and thousands of embryos and eggs stored in these tanks.
Right. This is a pretty important room.
Absolutely.
Can you give me a sort of a typical case study, if there is one even, of the woman who might come in here to freeze
her eggs?
Well,
a typical lady is someone in her maybe mid-30s who is not in a relationship. It's just about this affirmation that, look, I get that by the time I'm 40 to 42, my fertility is likely to be really decreased. I can't guarantee that I'm going to get into that right relationship space by then. So I'm going to assess my options and freeze my eggs.
And that generally costs upwards of $7,000, depending on how many rounds you do.
Tell me the best age for a woman to freeze her eggs.
Well, it's probably early 30s, and any later than mid to late 30s is probably getting a bit too old.
We met with someone who froze her eggs at 37. Mm-hmm. What are the chances of having a live birth with eggs frozen at 37?
At 37, that's less than 50%.
So like 5% or 49%?
No, it's somewhere between about a third and a 30-40% chance, maybe, depending on the number of the eggs and the quality of the eggs.
Okay, see, this is where, like, what flips me out is, like, you go to My Fertility, which is the government website, and it'll say something like, it's 17% chance if you freeze your eggs at 37. So, like, which one is it?
Well, I can't comment on somebody else's stuff. All I can just say is this is what our inferred numbers are.
So who do I believe?
That is a key question. Despite the pressure I feel to get pregnant early, older mums are actually on the rise. In the past 30 years, the number of Australian women conceiving in their 40s has tripled.
Hi, Dr. Clements, how are you?
Hi, good to meet you.
Good to meet you too. Thank you so much.
Come on through. Across all of Australia, all of New South Wales, and in this hospital, we've seen an increase. So it's very common. We don't really bat an eyelid when we have ladies having babies in their 40s. Currently I looked up the data,
right.
9% of our booked mums are 40 or older.
Right. That seems relatively high.
We probably have the largest percentage of over 40s mums booked here.
Mm-hmm.
That'll partly because of where we're located in the eastern suburbs of Sydney, and a lot of our mums are more professional women, and so they tend to have babies slightly later in life. So yeah, so we are an outlier. If you enter pregnancy otherwise well in your 40s, you are overwhelmingly likely to have a good pregnancy. So it's not to say there aren't any risks, but the message really is, once you conceive, you get over that early miscarriage risk, if you're otherwise a well woman, you are likely to have a really very normal pregnancy.
Are most of the women that you're seeing, do they conceive naturally or do they conceive via IVF, and particularly the older women?
I don't know the exact number, but something like 50-50. So plenty of our women who are over 40 are natural conceptions.
Despite their rising numbers, older mums are nothing new. Check this out. In 2017, there were 15 births for every 1,000 40 to 44-year-old women. But 100 years ago, nearly three times more women that age gave birth. Now, several things have changed since then, of course, but one of which is the way society perceives older mothers.
I had to overcome obstacles twice as hard because of my age. It was always a factor.
Tell us about, having your first child.
I was 41, and probably within 6 months, maybe a little bit more, we conceived naturally.
So you had a good pregnancy, but you've said that you've had to try really hard to have that good pregnancy.
Yeah.
Why?
When you start to make medical appointments and you meet with a general practitioner, I have to say that not very many of them were positive.
What were some of the things they were telling you?
You're too old. IVF isn't even going to work.
Really?
They put you into the same category as every woman in their 40s, and that could be women that are obese or women that have health issues, you know, women that have had to use IVF for whatever reason, they can't conceive naturally. So I just become that number,
right.
And nothing else is taken into consideration. I tried to walk away from that, and I think that was probably the best thing that I did through this process.
Yeah, I want some of like your vibe to rub off on me. Is there a number two?
I'm 44 now. We keep saying we'll give it until the end of the summer. We have to kind of get a little more motivated.
Some oysters.
Yeah,
some
yeah.
Strawberries.
Some wine.
A little bit of Barry White. Yeah, throw some wine in there.
Where's my tree? Are you showing me the tree?
I know we talk a lot about women being in their 40s. Have you had any conversations about men being in their 40s? I think your husband was maybe 45 when you were when you had the baby.
Yeah. We had never heard that. It was all about kind of me and am I able to conceive. It's kind of my fault if we can't get pregnant.
Right.
In fact, if a couple can't get pregnant, in half of those cases, that's right, half, it's got something to do with the man. And guess what, my dudes? Your fertility has a shelf life too. According to one European study, a 35-year-old bloke is half as likely to conceive than a man 10 years younger. Also, babies born to older fathers are more likely to experience complications such as a premature birth, seizures, and low birth weight.
I'll just wait for the world to hyperventilate about men delaying fatherhood. Do they even know that their sperm stops swimming right the older they get? Okay, what do you know about your fertility?
Nothing.
Are you stressing at 40 about your fertility?
Nah, not at all.
No, not at all. Up until what age do you think that you'll be able to kind of have a baby naturally?
I mean, I was under the assumption it was around to like 60. So.
Yeah? Do you ever think about your fertility?
Like never.
Never?
Well.
That is so unfair. So here's what we know. Men's fertility plays a role too. Older mothers are on the rise, and there were way more of them in the 1920s. So why do we keep talking about the fertility cliff? And where are the stats to back it up?
We approached the three biggest IVF companies in Australia. The first one told us that their stats come from a study done in the 1950s, but the study's findings were inconsistent with the stats on their website. The second just straight up didn't reply to our emails. The third company pointed us to yourfertility.org.au, and when we asked them where their stats came from, they pointed us to the American Society for Reproductive Medicine,
who couldn't give us a clear answer either.
The definitive study that the fertility industry uses is based on 209 women some 70 years ago in a small pocket of America. Even the study's author concedes that those women are not representative of American women, let alone multicultural Australian women some 7 decades later. Also, more recent studies turn that fertility cliff into slightly more of a downhill stroll. What do you say to more contemporary studies? Say there's one out of Denmark in 2013, I think one was out in 2004 in the States, that say that actually women over 35 have an 80% chance of conceiving naturally.
Sure, that's probably right.
Yes?
Yes, but for the 20% that don't get there, that's no consolation to them.
Okay, because I look at a study that says, oh, you have an 80% chance of conceiving after 35, and I think, why would I get my eggs frozen if that's the case?
Well, correct.
Why would I?
Because you might not meet the right person and get into the relationship space until you're in your 40s.
IVF companies such as Genea collectively pull in over $500 million a year in Australia. And for some couples, they're a godsend, no doubt. But I do wonder how many perfectly fertile women are paying thousands of dollars to freeze their eggs on the threat of a cliff that might not quite exist.
The difficulty with information like that, which is a kind of looks all scientific, doesn't really help you as an individual woman to know, well, what does that mean for me? I'm trying to plan my life and I've got this, that and the other to do. Is it all right to leave conceiving till I'm 40?
What's the best way to try and find out that information then?
The getting pregnant always is a little bit of a you have to actually try.
Yes.
For anyone.
That really does seem to be the only surefire way of knowing is try, and if you're pregnant, you're pregnant, and if you're not, you're not.
Yeah, yes. Very unsatisfactory.
Very much so.
Yeah, because people don't like that.
At the end of the day, it's not really about the numbers. It's about your body and your partner's body. I mean, these are going to be what determine the odds of you having children later in life, right? Not some graph that you found on the internet or anywhere, for that matter. And I think that's important because as women, we tend to kind of uproot our lives and our jobs and our partners and our careers based on this idea that maybe we can't have children later in life. And I would hate for us to be doing that without getting the full story.